So I've had Starlink for about 4 months and I've been testing it on my roof and it's been working really nice. I'm in LA, this is Sunset Boulevard, so that's why it's so loud. And the ultimate plan is now to put Starlink on my van. And I plan on putting it on the left side, right behind the panel next to the vent. But I want to mount it as flush as possible. So this is the challenge. And I've been looking at a lot of videos and what people did. And I think I'm gonna also try that. Basically cutting this plate off, putting another plate on the back and mounting it flat. My van is parked close to my place. So hopefully this is my only internet. And when my van is home, I'm home and I have internet at the house. And otherwise I'll take the internet with me wherever I go. So let's see how it goes. So first step is cutting this at a line that has a consistent height from the ground all around so that I can glue a flat plate on it. And to do that, I got this Accuscribe. I'll post a link in the comments. And this should allow me to draw this consistent height line. Then I'll Dremel this thing open and glue it to a flat base plate that I can then flat mount in between my racks on the roof. Gonna do 1 inch. I'm not gonna try to make it super flat. I think 1 inch is fine. Next step is to mount this distance holder to my rotary tool. So I bought this here. I'll post a link to, and then some bits. And now I'll just route this right around. I'm trying not to go deeper than the plastic, but I'm pretty high here. It should not be hitting any components, but still, I want to be very careful. So I made it around once. That worked pretty well. I just popped it open. I couldn't show everything because I only have one hand if I hold the phone. So I needed both hands, but okay, seemed to have worked great. Don't think I damaged anything. And 1 inch of height from the ground seems to be just the height that, so you don't have to cut this plate. You see this gray plate, that's the mount for the motors and the arm. And that goes until, yeah. And if I would have had it a little bit higher, I would have been in trouble. So 1 inch or lower, that's how you want to cut it. Okay, let me unplug the plugs and take this thing out. So I want to send the edge down, and I had some of those foam paddings, panels left that I have on my floor so that I protect the electronics when I'm sanding it. I'm not gonna leave it in there, we're just temporary right now. I'm gonna sand this down 80 first, 80 grit, and then I'm gonna go finer just to make it flat. So that popped right off. Now you really only have to go with the screwdriver underneath and then this glue pops off. Super easy. All right, so now easy to take that white gray cable out. So I got this piece out. This was a little bit more challenging than I thought. So this is the button that you press to release it from the stand. I was hoping to keep it intact, but I kind of broke it. But it's okay. It's okay. If I have to put it back on the stand, I'll figure out how to fix it on the stand. Now the nice thing is this plug has just some little clips that I can probably just unhook, and then I have the data cable intact, and then I'm gonna give it a try, see if it still works. I'm gonna mount it on this aluminum plate. That goes in the back of my rack. This is where the hole goes. This is my flat test setup before I put it on the van. Just put it flat, cooked it up. Here's my router. Let's see. Okay, so this is my base, aluminum plate, and then I have got some angle bars on the side, aluminum, and then a little bit of support. And this is gonna go under my first crossbar that supports the solar panel in the front.
And then I have a second one, specifically now for the Starlink at the very end of the van. That's gonna hold this. And so that's the base. And the flattened Starlink is right here. So this is exactly 1 inch high now, all the way around. So this is pretty flat. And the plan is to glue it right on here, like this. That's what I'm gonna do now. I bought some silica, so I'm gonna put it in just in case. Where is it? Here. So I'm gonna put a couple of those packs in here, just in case. But I'm gonna try to make it as waterproof as I can. I have all the right stuff. This is what I have. Adhesive sealant 5200. So it's gonna be gooped all around. So before I glue this on, I'm gonna rough it up on the outsides. I roughed this up just so that the glue that I have sticks as good as possible. So this is the cable that was in the dish. Pulled it out. This connects to the PCB, and I'm gonna wire it through my roof. This is what I'm gonna mount on the roof. So this goes through before. Hopefully I get it through this. So I got it through. This was a little bit of a challenge to get this plug through this hole, but it fit. So now I'm starting to assemble this, and then I'm gonna fit it through here, and then I can start with the gluing. So now I'm gonna find a grommet that fits here, fits the cable. This is the one. Okay, now we got this cut through. You got here, you got a little grommet in here. So it's getting there. I'm using this piece as a template so that I know where to put the glue. So I'm gonna place some of these silica packs in here. All right, the time has come. I'm gonna put a very big bead of this sealant right around here, super thick. I'm gonna sit it in there, and I'm gonna have a second layer on top later, but this is the first one that really just hopefully seals it. Okay, I quickly taped it on because I want to put it on the van. Final test before I glue it. Bounty stars offline online. All right, seems to work. So I see for the first time a message now that I don't have the motors connected. So I'm gonna get it down from the van now and glue it together. Now I'm gonna put it on. Okay, this is the scary part. Make sure you don't drop it. Connector. Come on. Connector is in. It clicked. All right, here we go. Dropping it down. Sounds like I live on a racetrack, I know. But this is Sunset Boulevard in Los Angeles. And every Wednesday night, there is a motorcycle racers racing up and down Sunset. It's a thing. Okay, I got the sandbags. Now I'm pressing it down. I'm pretty happy with
the whole gluing process. It seems to bond so far fairly nice. So while my Starlink dish is curing, it takes 7 days until this 5,200 cures, but so not in a rush to put it up yet. I'm cleaning out the van, preparing everything. I have to take those panels out here because I'm gonna mount Starlink right here next to the fan up on top, and so I'm gonna drill a hole. Yesterday I went ahead and I also bought this Weboost. I always wanted to do it, then I didn't do it, then I closed the roof up, and then now this is an opportunity to get another cable in from the roof. Got the Weboost too, so I hope I'm well connected in the future. Yeah, so this is gonna be my electronics compartment. I've got fuses in here, so I'm gonna clean all this up. This is where the Starlink goes, this is where my Weboost goes. Everything is gonna be in the center. So I just need to go in here. Hopefully I just need to take this one panel, these two panels out, and I can leave all this in. Let's see. I got it off. That's great. This is pretty easy. I can fiddle the cables through here into my power cabinet. Awesome. I was so worried that I had to take all this stuff down, but now I'm quite happy. There's no way back. I drilled the holes. I ran out of daylight. Got one hole for my cell booster and the other one for the Starlink. Okay. This guy in here. Things here. Sweet. I think this is pretty good. Let's see that we don't forget any tools up there. Looks all good. Okay, we have arrived at this point and I'm hooking up Starlink for the first time. First time mounted to the van. So, okay, before I put the power in, let's hook up this cable. Come on, there it is. Hooked up, and now power up Starlink and see if you get anything. Starlink, yeah, okay, gotta warn you, it's rush hour, it's always super slow around this time. 9 o'clock, 10 o'clock is horrible, but we're online, right? That's a good sign. We're online. Speed test, temporary unavailable. Damn. All right, we'll try the speed test later. Too bad. I'm tired. This was a successful day. Everything on the roof is done. And now we got the two cables coming in. One for Starlink set up. The other one for my cell booster. So it's working. It's already powered by the van. Now I just gotta make it neat. I want to try to find a shorter cable. I don't know, this is way too long, this Starlink cable. I'm gonna see if I can find something short or make my own cable. Because I only need to go from here into my cabinet. Very short. Daylight. Cell booster's up and the Starlink is up. So I finished cabling everything here. Got the cables through. This is my electronic cabinet. Now I need to design and 3D print a holder, or let's say a mount for this Weboost. Basically, I want a sleeve that I can sleeve over it and then mount it on the far side there, like this. So I've 3D printed this little piece. I'm gonna put it, link in the comments. I think that works really nice because that just sleeves over this, and now I can attach it. I might even attach it upside down on my cupboard. So this is the inside. All cabled up, all done. This is my electronic compartment. This has always been my electronic compartment for cameras, drone. Now I added the Starlink. I had some space up here. So this is a solid connection to that 8020 holding up the router. I've got an Ethernet port here because I want to get an additional router as well. Because this one doesn't route internal traffic through, so for some of my development I need that. So I'm gonna get another router. And yeah, on the outside here I've got the Weboost. This thing gets extremely hot, so I'm actually a little bit unhappy about the heat. It's just wasting energy like crazy with the heat. So I had to put it on the outside and we'll see how it performs. So I heard mixed results, but I'll give an update. So hopefully I got some stronger cell signal. I've got permanent Wi-Fi. My security cameras are permanently connected to the internet. Yeah. To the deep clean here with all my electrical system. Here's my Tesla battery, 24 volt system, powers all the whole thing. I have another video about this Tesla battery if anybody's interested in the electrical. I think it's time to put the bat back in and get ready to test this out on the weekend. Okay, I'm in my van and I want to do another speed test. Okay, 117 down, 2.9 up.
Okay, so Starlink test on the road. We're here in Ventura County right now. Yeah, got like 50 megabit down, 60.
So I've been testing it for a couple days and I must say the speeds are very similar to what I've seen before when the servos were connected and it was pointing to the north. Now it points always straight up. The speeds are so variable here. Sometimes we have a rush hour and it's below 10 megabit per second, and sometimes it's close to 200 megabit per second. And even with this mount now pointing up, I've seen speeds over 170 megabit per second in this short time. So this is good, happy with this, and I'm gonna keep testing it. But for now, I'm gonna wrap this project and try to get a video out.